Welcome to Home Biz Tax Talk. My name is Lissandra Everett. I am the Home Biz Tax Lady, where I help home business owners win the tax game. Home Biz Tax Talk airs Monday through Friday, 9 o'clock-ish, and you can come here to get your questions answered about your home business taxes. Okay, so let's talk about some celebrity news, right? So I shared this article that I saw yesterday about the whole Nicki Minaj Geoffrey Owens thing, right? So if you don't know what's going on, what happened is, you know, there was a lady a couple weeks ago that spotted Geoffrey Owens. Geoffrey is the guy that played Elvin on The Cosby Show. Well, anyway, she spotted him working at Trader Joe's. She took a picture of him. It went viral. Everybody thought that, you know, she was trying to job shame him. And she said that was not the case, but what ifs? Right. And so, you know, he since stopped working there and just some other stuff transpired. And I think now he's going to be working with Tyler Perry. Okay. Well, in the midst of all of that, you know, Nicki Minaj said, hey, I'm going to give him $25,000. Right. Then at some point, I guess she decided she was going to change her mind. And then social media came for her. And from what I understand, just totally drug her. So then she, you know, gave him the $25,000, which he then gave to charity. But this is, I got to tell y'all the tax stuff behind the stuff, right? So, okay, so here's the deal. All right. So the first thing is, because Nicki Minaj, if she as a person gave a gift to another person, that is not considered a charitable contribution. So there is no tax deduction there for her. Okay. And the second thing is, because the gift is more than $14,000, she's got to file a gift tax return. Okay. Now she may not owe any gift taxes because she can subtract that from her lifetime exclusion, which is like some millions of dollars, right? But anyway, she's still got to file this gift tax return. At least it would be in her best interest to do so. It's more of an information return. Like I said, she might not owe any taxes. So when you're giving a large gift to a person, you may be subject to a gift tax, not the receiver, not the person receiving the money, but the person giving the money may be subject to a gift tax. There's some other stuff involved. There's lifetime exclusions and all that, but anything over $14,000, in cash is, you know, yeah, it's a gift. Probably got to file a gift return. Now, Geoffrey, like I said, he was like, okay, cool, but I'm donating this money to charity. Now, that's great. And if he donated to a qualified charity, then he is eligible to receive a tax deduction. But, you know, charitable contributions are subject to income limitations. And so for 2018, I do believe it is increased to 60% of your adjusted gross income. So depending on what his adjusted gross income is for the year, he may not be able to deduct all of that $25,000. So when you're giving, you know, your charitable donations and everything, you know, first of all, you know, with cash, you know, make sure that you have a canceled check, or you have a statement. Like usually if you're giving to your church or something like that, you get an annual statement. And most organizations, if you donate cash to them, you get a letter or something stating how much you gave for the year. So you got to have some sort of record of that. Okay. And if you are donating goods, right? If you're donating like, you know, clothes or dishes or something like that, it is the fair market value of what you're donating, not what you paid for it. So, you know, even though you might have paid, you know, $900 for some Jimmy Choo boots, by the time you donate them, they might be worth $100, $200. Okay. So, you know, if you've worn them and all that stuff, yeah, if you don't get to deduct what you paid for it, it's the fair market value. And donating your services, for my business owners, please do not fall into this trap. you cannot write off the amount that you would have charged someone. If you donate your time to an organization, you're just donating your time. You don't get to deduct a dollar amount based on that. You can deduct if you use some supplies or something like that. Like if you had to, you know, like I have a client who is a landscaper and she helped, you know, some art society, you know, with their whole landscaping deal. So, you know, her labor time is not tax deductible, but the materials that she used, you know, had to buy, you know, plants and all of that stuff, that stuff is tax deductible, but not your time. Okay. So please, I have my, you know, my business owner saying, hey, you know, I donated my service time, you know, to my church. You could be a social media manager or something. How much can I deduct? The answer is zero. You see me? Zero, boo. Zero. Okay. Now, but anyway, so back to this, income limitation. So, you know, like I said, his gift is going to be subject to his income limitation. But what happens to the part that you can't use? Well, then you get to carry it forward for up to 5 years or until it's used up, but not beyond that 5 years. So it doesn't just go away, but it, you know, but you only have 5 years to use it. So, yeah, so that's the, you know, that's the whole thing. So, you know, when you're talking about gifting money, you know, just know that, you know, there's tax implications. Okay. You know, there are certain gifts that are non-taxable. Like if you're, gifting like, wait a minute. I don't want to lie to you. Let me make sure I have it right. Cause I just lost my train of thought. But sorry, I'm typing in y'all's ear. All right. But I want to make sure that, that I tell you the right thing, right? Because we don't want false and erroneous information going around. So if you are, you know, spouses, if, you know, a husband or what, this is what the law says. Okay. Don't come for me. All right. Well, husband and wife, then, that's not considered a gift. If it's paid directly to an educational or medical institution for someone's medical bills or tuition expenses, and it doesn't have to be a child or relative, for that exception. Okay. So just want to make sure I had that right. And, it's cause, you know, hey, cause taxes, you just gotta be right. You either right or you not. Okay. But anyway, so just know that, you know, in gifts of in excess of $14,000, definitely you want to file a gift return, even if you are not subject to the gift, to the gift tax. Anything under $14,000, that you don't have to file a gift tax. Now, a married couple can, you know, split a gift. So, you know, it's $14,000, under $14,000 for the wife, under $14,000 for the husband. And, you know, so you can actually gift somebody, you know, $26,000 and it's not going to, and you don't have to file a return because it's actually split. There, this is why you need tax people, okay, to make sure that you get this part right. Like for real. But yeah, but just know that, you know, even for you, the giver of the gift, like I have a gentleman right now that, you know, is like, hey, you know, I donated all of this Bitcoin. Okay. Well, if you gave it to a charitable organization, then you need to know the fair market value of the Bitcoin on the day that you gave it. So there's lots of stuff to think about when you're, when you're gifting things. Yes, we want to be charitable. We want to be generous, but we also got to get the paper right. That's the bottom line, you guys. So yeah, so that's, so it ain't just so simple as here's, you know, $25,000 and go and do what you do, boo. No, you got to really think about those things. Okay. So, all right, you guys, I love doing news. Okay. That's always fun. Oh, and this isn't even part of it, but I have to talk about it because it's so funny. What is her name? Tiffany Haddish. You know, she made the Accounting Today news about her post about the IRS, you know, like, you don't even say thank you. Y'all taking 50% of my money. And I'm sitting here saying, boo, You don't have somebody on your team to help you manage your money, or you wouldn't be paying that much in taxes. Stacy said you can add Bitcoin to your taxes if you're donating Bitcoin. Okay, you can actually donate Bitcoin to a qualified charity. Be clear on the qualified charity part, okay? Let's be clear on that. So yeah, you need to know the fair market value of the Bitcoin when you donate it. So I want to make sure that that is clear. But the qualified charity part is what is important, okay? Just letting you know. All right, you guys, thank you so much for tuning in to Home Biz Tax Talk. Again, we air Monday through Friday, 9 o'clock-ish, and you can come here to get your questions answered about your home business taxes. All right, have a great day, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.